A number of you are asking the internets, how do the internets cross the ocean?
A very good question. We have decided we will enlist our interns to help answer it. Interns!
Yes, Miss Erna and Miss Weena?
Two of you are going to go on a magic adventure to figure out how the internet crosses the ocean.
Yes.
You and you.
Everybody else take a hike. Bye. All right. Okay, intern number one.
Yes, Weena?
We're sending you on an all-expenses-paid cruise across the Atlantic. Here are your tickets. Have fun, kid.
Intern number two.
My name is Theodora.
Ah, well, we're flushing you down the toilet.
What?
Mm-hmm. Take her away.
Oh.
Yoink. Bon voyage.
Our motives will shortly become clear. You see, the internet crosses the ocean through a series of underwater tubes.
But this is a dumpy working ship, not a cruise liner.
Bon voyage!
A ship carrying cable starts off from shore, unrolling the spool onto the seafloor. They keep it straight using floats and a machine that fixes it to the ocean floor, like this. The first cable that crossed the Atlantic was laid in 1858.
Wow, those cables are old. Is that why my animes take so long to download from Japan?
No. If we were still using those old things, you would get like one tweet a day via telegram. They lay new cables all the time now, but sometimes they get damaged. Like sometimes ships drop an anchor onto a cable and cut off part of the internet.
Oops.
Japan's fine. There's lots of cable connections to Japan. They have what's called redundancy.
I love you, the internet!
But some places in Africa only have a few connections. So when I'm trying to raise awareness for issues there, news from the front lines could easily be cut off. When there were protests in Egypt, some shady characters were caught trying to cut the cable. And one time, the cable was even attacked by sharks.
How do they keep that from happening?
They actually wrap the cables in Kevlar, that bulletproof stuff. Really though, cables don't get cut that often, or like, shot at.
So it's not even satellites like I thought. When I watch my anime, it's swimming through the water, not flying through the air.
Yep, mostly only cell phone traffic goes by satellite. Most of the stuff crossing the ocean goes through the cable.
So now we know. The internet, while crossing the ocean, really does go through a series of tubes.
Ah, welcome back, number one. How was it?
Intern is tanned and rested, and has done the world a service by ensuring internet's connections.
And how about you, intern number two?
My name is Theodora.
Well done, Theodora. We will credit you on our Kickstarter.
I'm hungry.
Let us attack this plate of spaghetti with the fervor of sharks attacking internet tubes.
Yay, no more cardboard soup for intern.
Cardboard spaghetti, though.
Do you like sushi?